But when they sell in the train, it is not samosa. It is samosas, samosas. Isn't samosa amazing? You can even have it for breakfast. As a snack, it is just awesome. But when you make a chaat with the samosa, it takes to a different league altogether. When I was working in Delhi as a management trainee, we used to go to a place which is close to this railway station. This guy used to make awesome big samosa, and along with that, you know, the gulab jamun, my God, what wonderful days this were. You can make these memories real by making it yourself at home and enjoy. Making samosa, take all-purpose flour, add salt. In this, add little bit of ajwain. For my samosas to be super tasty, I always use butter. For 100 grams of flour, use 20 grams of butter. So you take 1 kg of flour, you're going to use 200 grams, 20% of butter. Just crumble it. This way of mixing the butter into the flour, the short crust method, will make your samosas perfect for the bite. In this, add water and make it into a tight dough. Just like the way you make puri dough, little more tighter than that. Knead the dough slightly and let the dough rest. That's when the dough becomes nice and perfect for samosa. Boil the potatoes really nice, mash them. And there are a couple of ways we do it. We cook the masala and add to the potatoes. Other one is the raw masala. For the raw masala, all we're going to do is add a little bit of turmeric, add chili powder. If you want, you can also add a little bit of pepper powder, cumin powder. This gives a lot of flavor. Chaat masala, chopped coriander, a little bit of green chili. This is like nice raw masala dar. And I love to add a little bit of green peas. Add salt and mix this masala. And this raw masala is what they use on the street side vendors. Squeeze in a little bit of lime juice and this shall be perfect. After you mix this, this masala has to be tasty. Only then your samosas will be good. After resting for some time, the dough will become nice, perfect. And it will be a little bit cloudy dough. So divide the dough. The fat that is there in the dough will prevent the dough from sticking to the table. So just first roll it a little bit rounder like this. And then, you know, make it into oval shape. For this size is for big samosas. You can take a smaller dough for smaller samosas. Now, you know, look at the way I have rolled it into sheet like this, then cut it to half. Now what you do, take water on the edges, apply the water, okay? Look at this, very simple. What this will do is, it will seal the edges. Now the cone is going to be like this, there is an overlap. So when you put the cone, just put your finger, you know, I am good at this fingering, so like this. Now you got the big stomach. The stomach is big for the samosa. Just put how much ever masala you want in this. But first seal it on one side. Okay? Then crisscross. Now look at this. This is what is a nice professional. Seal it like this. And this is perfect. Make it big like this and make it sit like this. So this cone will come out nice and crispy when you fry, so is this edges. But if the oil is cold, then the samosas will open up. So in the medium hot oil, drop the samosas. You know, fry samosas till they are nicely colored and perfect. The big samosas. And now I'm going to make slightly smaller samosas. This is like wife and husband samosas talking to each other. And the wife samosa is telling the husband samosa, you're always wrong. For smaller samosas, make it slightly thinner. Just apply water. Same way on both sides. And edges always have to be nice and perfect. Now, take the aloo masala, stuff it. Whenever you make these samosas, just make sure that the edges you press little bit. And make all the samosas like this. And then we're going to enjoy it. These are the beautiful samosas, but when they sell in the train, it is not samosa. It is samosas, samosas, samosas. 5 rupai ko ek, 10 rupai. You know, the leftover samosa sheet, cut them for the papadi chaat. Just drop them and fry them till they're slightly golden in color. and you can make papdi chaat, anything with this. These samosas just melt in your mouth and they are super tasty. Wow. And the edges, Queen Victoria and my son, they love chaats. So we are going to make some chana dal and samosa chaat. For making this chaat, you can use garbanzo or even I am using the chana dal which I have boiled. Add some oil, chili, add the dal, some chili powder, some chaat masala, pinch of garam masala, cumin powder, little bit of coriander powder, cook them, chopped coriander. In this, you can add a little bit of tomato, maybe you want to add some onion, and just cook this. Add a little bit of salt. In this, you can add some mint chutney, some sweet chutney. Make this nice chatpata. You can add a little bit of lemon juice. Just mash the samosa pieces and add the samosa pieces on top of this. And we're going to do jing bang, jing bang, bing bang, jing bang, jing bang, bing bang. The Queen Victoria loving this chaat. We love this chaat. Okay, make it tasty. Do not overcook the samosas. Now, transfer onto the plate with a little bit of saucy thing. On this, add fresh onion, a little bit of tomato, you know, some save, and in this add some crushed papdi for extra effect, and finish it off by a little bit of green chutney here and there, sweet chutney here and there. Now, you know, my son likes it slightly different, but what we love is nice little bit of curd. So here and there, little bit of curd. How is it, baby?
Super?
You like it? And on top of this, little bit of spiciness for him and maybe some coriander. And you want little extra crunch, you can always, you know, drop one or two papdi. Here is a samosa chaat for my son who is handling the camera. You know, all you need to do is make one for yourself. Wow. Dear friends, my final tip. Always after eating samosa, you got to eat gulab jamun with ice cream. Oh, come on, ice cream. The combination of gulab jamun and ice cream. Now is the time to say ding chik ding chik ding chik ding chik ding chik ding chik ding chik.